And it gave the verse. And I went and looked at it in the good is. And you know the word in the good is Bahititu. Bahititu. And it was the only true God is the Bahitawi. Is the Bahitawi. You know, and I was like, oh, wow. Oh, wow. Remember, it says that our Lord, it's evident that our Lord, in the same book, Hebrews, there was a change of law, right? And, you know, there was a change of law from the Levitical to the Judahite, right? And Christ says that ye worship what you know not. We know what we worship for salvations of Judah or the Jews. If you go to chapter 7, you're done, no. For it is evident, chapter 7, 14, that our Lord sprang out of Judah. Of which tribe Moses spake nothing concerning the priesthood. Wow. Wow. Moses didn't speak anything, but that doesn't mean that Daddy didn't give I and I the priesthood. You know, in other words, he didn't. Can you remember? You remember when Christ was transfigured? And just a note for the I and them. Hopefully we'll have another maybe reasoning by, before, on the 17th. You know, the 17th is the Rosh Hashanah. I was looking at an Ethiopic or the Ethiopian, the Ethiopia Kingdom of God. If you go to that, though a lot of this stuff is in English, but they have in English and Amharic, the Kingdom of God website on the internet. I like the Nebura Id, this brother Ermias, not the Prince Ermias, but another Ermias, who is Nebura Id. He was appointed as the keeper of Aksum. But I think during the time of the revolution, him and other people fled, you understand, because of all that was going on. Anyway, he has a site where he's a part of Haile Selassie, the first crowd, except that, you know, we've had some communication with him, you know, in writing. And he is one of a superior intellect. He just thinks that His Majesty brought so much modernization, and that is what ruined the people, instead of saying that the people basically fell because of a lack of the knowledge of God. In other words, that's why Haile Selassie caused the Bible to be printed. You know, in other words, Haile Selassie caused, are you there? Haile Selassie caused our own form of the Protestant Reformation. In a sense. In other words, not the Protestant, but what he did was do the same thing that Martin Luther did, that William Tyndale did, you understand, and then King James got the credit for it. But he caused the Bible to be published, you understand, so that the young and the old, because the only books that the Ethiopian, the faithful Ethiopian really had, basically was Psalms, was the Zewetir Elot, the daily, the constant prayer, was many of the prayers of Kiddushin and Gemarion, which are good, you understand, but that is still not, you know what I mean, because remember, Kiddushin and Gemarion calls her son our Savior Lord, and that is only proper, you understand, and he is her Savior too, you understand what I'm saying, so we have to recognize that those things were the only spiritual food that the average Ethiopian had, the Psalms, you understand, the daily psalms, the constant prayers, and some portions of the liturgy. But what His Majesty did was he now opened that book and caused for the young and the old to be able to read the scripture for themselves. But you know, in a priesthood system, ecclesiastical system like Ethiopia was, that gained him certain friend enemies. You know why? Because now the average Christian can read, you understand, can read the Bible and say, Father Priest, why am I calling you Father Priest? You know, they can ask certain questions, you know what I mean? You know, and that basically, that was one of the reasons why there was also a conspiracy among the priesthood against His Majesty and the Abuna of the time, Tewophilos. He did not bless the emperor. He did not bless the imperial family. He basically blessed, this is in 1974-75, he basically blessed the communist socialistic derg. You know what I mean? And that was a powerful signal that, and that's why the churches, remember, there's an inner church, there's a true church in the professing church. You know what I'm saying? And that's what it says, try every spirit, so that you will know who is of God or not. It's not because people say, I say Lord, Lord 25,000 times a day. Yeah, that's good. You understand? But it's better if you do what the Lord, Lord say. You know what I mean? Anyway, on that particular note, brothers and sisters, give thanks for allowing I and I the opportunity to share what the King of Kings in Christ has laid upon I and I heart and I and I mind to share with the I them. And I'm going to yield the floor for a moment for anyone else to say yay, yay, say nay, nay, or say shenay, nay, whatever. You understand?
I won't.
I don't know if you're, some of y'all who are on this coast, on the East Coast, it's about the 2 a.m. hour. Y'all out in California, y'all just in good time, right? Y'all in good time, right? Right, cuz? Right, cuz? Cuz? Anything, right, cuz? You know, and then, sister, was that Sister Salama I heard from earlier?
Yes.
Okay. And I don't know where you're in VI time. I don't know VI time is. Is VI time? That's good. Yeah, that's good. That's good. Then that means that means that it's like late in the morning for you too. Then that's good.
Yes, sir.
Yes, my brothers and sisters. I know it was maybe a bit much, but the verse I really want you to think on, just think on 10:20. 10:20 of Hebrews, man. And then just read the full by a new and a living way, which he has made holy for I and I through the veil, that is to say, his flesh. So we have been, you know, glorifying the fact that, yes, he is black, because the enemy has deceived Europeans, had deceived white folks. You understand? Yeah. They were deceived. Remember, we already been deceived, our black kingdoms, by the devil. Remember, the devil doesn't really care about black or white, really. You know what I mean? He felt that this was his. And Adam was given something that would belong to him. So he has really, even the people who be worshiping the evil powers and everything, yeah, they don't know that's the wrath that the Lord is going to unleash against them. That the very same demons that they're worshiping is what's going to be unleashed on them. You understand? Because he said that they're kept for a day, an hour, a year. They've been kept for a certain time. I hope it's not 2012, because I hope we have more time to build until, spiritually. But even if it is 2012, you understand, may everyone have root in themselves, you know what I mean?
Yes,
in themselves, in the King. And don't be disturbed by these things that, you know what I mean? You know, don't be disturbed if the veil drops and you see some monsters, some, you know. You know.
Be a lucky conqueror. Face it and deal with it in Christ Yeshua.
Yeah, put on your full armor and just get into. Yeah, please listen to this again. Listen to this reasoning again and slow it down, because I just try to go at a, knowing this was being recorded as well, go at a lively pace, because we're not all on the same time, but so one can go through it. If there's any question about anything that was said, we might have made a little mistake here or there. We're not sure, but in spirit we know we didn't make any mistake about it, but might have made a mistake in word or something that we might have said, because we caught ourselves a couple of places, even in the reading, trying just to read through it within the time that we had. You understand, and that we have and everything. I just thought it was just very important for us to just recognize that, you know, in reading the Old Testament, let us read the Old Testament as those who did in the New Testament, recognizing that that was a shadow, that now we have the substance. You know, like, you know, if you see a shadow projected, you know, like you ever see a shadow somewhere and you ever turn around and look and try to see what is throwing, what is casting that shadow. So while we're reading the Old Testament, make sure we recognize that we're looking at a shadow, and we should always trace that shadow to the New Testament revelation, you know, to what is, to Yeshua, who is, in that sense, who has already cast that shadow. But now we can look at the substance, and that we have that substance in our head, in our heart, in our triune, in our trinity, our spirit, soul, and body, Yehovah's, and we are more than conquerors. You understand? Because John wants us to reign. You understand? He wants us to reign. He done, you know, he said the revolution is good for the people, I'm for the revolution. He done did, you know what I mean? All that. Now is now it comes down to, or comes up, or now we have to come up to him. You know what I mean? Come up to him. He done already fulfilled his part. He vouchsafed it. And I say hallelujah, because I've testified I was not, I don't know if I would even be about the Bible or Christ or whatever if it wasn't for his majesty. I don't know if that's some of your testimonies too. You know what I mean? I honestly, I was like, what is all this stuff about, man? This stuff is fake, man. This stuff is all a whitewash and everything. And then it's just his majesty's testimony, man. Just his, you know, and I give thanks, man, for real, because, you know, would have been down with I'm happy I'm not after no other God, you know what I mean? Following after no other God, you know what I mean? But actually, this is the God of our fathers, because even though our parents and other folks might think, you know, they might think, oh, you're talking about this Haile Selassie, stuff and so on. If we really are rooted and grounded in that truth, we recognize there ain't no other. It's really no other. It's just a continual revealing and this end time fulfillment of that revelation. You know, and the Antichrist already has come. You know, the Antichrist already came. You understand, when they whitewash and they did all this and they said, we're coming in Jesus' name and they're killing people. You understand, you know, like, you know, they said that the Incas in South America, they were, maybe it wasn't the Incas, but it was another South American tribe, they were rushing to the Portuguese. When the Portuguese came, they saw the Portuguese carrying the cross. And they recognized that cross. They recognized the cross as a symbol that they were to look forward to. And so they're running to the Portuguese, and the Portuguese just hack them up. And that it's taken like a long time for a lot of those peoples to really get over, that antichrist behavior that some of our Christian brothers, and they were our brothers in Christ, even the Portuguese, but they were deceived. You understand? When they, you know, they were following a middleman, the Pope. You know what I mean? And it's just interesting how so many peoples was turned off before they could get turned on. You know what I mean? How they was turned off. It's like kind of like what they be doing. You know, in a lot of different places, like, you know, abusing people in God's name. You understand? And so these people would never want to hear another thing. You might meet some of these brothers and sisters who have been so wounded and hurt. They don't want to hear about Bible. They're like, you know, talking about Bible. Because the person who probably abused them was talking some Bible stuff, even though it probably was nothing really in the real scripture. You know what I mean? But that's part of it. Exactly. That was part of the devil's thing to turn, because Satan knows that if anyone get into this and this gets into them, he has lost. He has lost his. First of all, he's losing his 6,000-year-old case. If it's a 6,000-year, if it's not a 13,000-year or a 26,000, or however old his case has been, he is losing that case right there. You understand? And then he has built up, every time another brother or sister comes to the truth of the King of Kings and his Christ, there's a powerful adversary of his majesty's adversary. In other words, there's a powerful enemy. Satan knows that he has a powerful enemy every time a brother or sister gets the truth for themselves. You know what I mean? Because that's one less person that they can fool, and then potentially more people are going to be turned on to this. That's why they're trying to bring up all this hate speech, bullying, even that stuff with that Muslim thing going on right there. Watch what happened. They're going to say, you cannot talk about this or that. Well, we're just talking about Rastafari. We're talking about what they, no, you can't talk, because in that video it was just nothing but showing how they lynched and brutalized black men and how that was just like Christ. And they said, oh, this is hate speech. All right, anyway. We rejoice, and still we understand, we know Satan's Achilles heel. We know what Babylon's Achilles heel is now. You know what I mean? In other words, you know, by doing that, we flip it. When we don't get into our flesh, but we stay in his spirit, we recognize, oh, for real now. So you mean if we talk about how the black man's problem is really a God problem and turn them to their father and their elder brother, That's what you really don't want people to know, because you like it when we keep blaming the white man, because you see, the devil not playing no sides. He's not on the black man's side. He's not on the white man's side. He want to destroy humanity. Don't we get it? You know what I mean? He want to destroy humanity. So one time he might have used some of our ancient civilizations, all Babylon, all that was black. We done know, but it fell down like a piece of shit. You understand, when it went after false demonic doctrines and entities. You know what I'm saying? So it's not for us to, even ancient Egypt, we love it, you understand, because it's black, you understand, that we can see certain things, but it also fell too. That's why God called that people, that Hebrew people out. And the Hebrew people wasn't just Israelites. We keep thinking the Hebrew people were just Israelites. No, it wasn't Israelites. It was a certain type of people who believe a certain type of thing, as we as Rastafari are a certain type of people who hold true a certain type of truth. You know, so that does not mean that, you understand, that there is not a racial level of it. But I'm saying that is, you know, that's that we can trample under our feet, really. You know what I mean? In a sense, it's bigger spiritual fish to fry, in other words. You over? Because you might go after the black person over there, and that one is like in the Matrix, has been downloaded with some Decepticon virus. And then you might have a Hispanic or European or Asian or another brother over here, and you turn their back, your back on them, and they're the one who have submitted to his will. So who really is your brother? Who really is your sister? You know what I'm saying? Just a little warning the Holy Spirit gave me that I just have to share with others, you know, and I'm beginning more and more now walking in it, really begin to see what it's all about. And this doesn't mean we deny that Christ is an Ethiopian. That's a fact. That's a natural fact. You know, we were willing to accept Christ as being Caesar Borgias, you know, before we knew any better. Many of us were willing to accept that. You understand? But now we know it's a lie, so we don't accept the lie, because that will cause us to fall from grace. You know, grace and truth. So my brothers and sisters, I say shalom as we're going into the next couple of days, into a new year, a new cycle and everything. We're already in our solar cycle, and now that light of the sun is taking about 6-7 days to reach the moon, until we have the Rosh Hashanah, our Hebrew New Year, Yovas. I mean, there's no big, so much celebrations or whatnot. I mean, there's things people do and stuff like that, but I'm looking at what the Torah says. You know, in other words, what does the Scripture say? But it's important for us to understand these cycles, because the heavens is God's time. You know what I mean? That's why somebody got knocked off again.
So.
In these ways,
No, I've been listening. I've been on mute. My baby's having a fit. That's all.
It's
a blessing to everyone. Yeah,
maybe just say she's having a situation. No, I'm thinking about that word fit.
She's having a situation.
yeah, that word fit. Yeah, we don't want to give them, like, we don't give no place, we're no place to the enemy. You know, no place. They're not having, Babylon's having a fit. Babylon have a fit. Because Babylon's not fit.
Oh, yes.
Mm. I will, my brothers and sisters. Hopefully soon we can even do this maybe a little more, even on Skype. You know, we're going to try to go in the new year, if Jah will. And well, he wills, if, you know, if we will in him, his will is with us, go to the Skype coming up. We're still trying to test some of the technologies, but we also want to remember the least amongst us that might not have all of that. You know, I don't know how the technicals, all that work out, but something that I want just to put forward, you know, hopefully we can, you know, do some Skype-y, you know, do some Skypes and stuff like that. You know, all depends on what's what. Many have been asking. I don't want to be holding back on the technology. Brother Wyndham Toby, are you still there?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, yeah. You know, so some of our high-tech people, you know, I'm like, oh, let's just keep doing this old school. You know, so don't want to, it says, his man says, leaders, and we are leaders, you understand, in our respective gifts or callings or fields amongst our other brothers and sisters must always stay ahead, you know what I mean? And, you know, and try to see, okay, what's the, you know, see if it's really, but test it. We got to prove all things and hold fast to that which is good. And if Skype is good, you understand, then maybe we can step up to that, you know. So I'm just putting that out there for right now. But the thing I want everyone to really take out of this particular sabbatical portion is Deuteronomy, from the Torah portion, Deuteronomy chapter 28, verses 1 to verse 14, the blessing. I know we've been talking about the curses, and we got into this because the curse of disobedience, and we did that, and slavery is about the curse of disobedience. All right, I think we got the idea now. We got the idea, but we need some barakat. So chapter 28, verses 1, yeah, from verse 1 to verse 14, because if our ancestors held to that, and we also held to that, then all this cursing stuff never would have happened. So now in Yeshua, you understand, it is once again blessing. You understand, it's once again blessing for us in the King of Kings and His Christ. There's nothing that says that Africa or Ethiopia has to be that way. In fact, we get to recognize she brought it on herself. You understand? You know what I mean? In a sense, just like many times, in some cases, we have to recognize in some things and not going through the guilt trip thing, like where people be like, oh, I'm so bad, I'm so wrong. Well, we do that sometimes. You know, it's like making ourselves cry and everything like that. No, let's grow up, let's be mature. But in some things, we got to admit that we do bring some things on ourselves, whether it's what we say, whether it's how we act. And remember, grace and truth go together. You know what I mean? Grace and truth go together because He is the God of truth. You understand? And the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of truth. You know? And the Holy Spirit sometimes must reprove us, you know, and bring to us these aspects of ourselves. And if we're not in the Word, we'll think the Holy Spirit is like a demon because it's saying things to us that's making us look at the bad things that we still are carrying. No, the Holy Spirit said, get rid of that, you know, get rid of that. You understand? So you can be perfect, you know. So let's look at the blessings, you understand. Let's really look at these blessings right here. I mean, these blessings are beautiful, you know what I mean? And these blessings are ours if we will make our wills obedient to His influence, and all really we have to do is behold Him. It's to receive, you know, receive Him. You know what I mean? Receive what His Word says. And if we have a little trouble or difficulty understanding it, find a brother or sister and can we talk about this? You know, can we talk? You know what I mean? You know, and true, everybody may have different things to do at different times, but we must find a time to talk on Jah's Word. Otherwise, I really wonder what kind of spirit you got in you. You know what I mean?
Right.
I mean, for real. I mean, I'm just being straight up. I'm not going to say sweet nothings. A sweet nothings is basically nothing. you know, just sweetly. You know what I mean? You know, so, and I know sometimes people find the Bible boring. I mean, nobody would admit that. See, the Holy Spirit already checked me on that. That's why I can bring that out there. That's why if you do find, like, you know, they don't find themselves motivated the way they should, that's where prayer comes in, as it says in James. If we ask wisdom or we ask these things, just don't doubt. I mean, come on. You don't doubt that the electricity going to come on after you pay your bill, right? And what is our payment to our Father? It's thanks and praise. So you don't doubt that the light's going to come on, right? If you pay your bill, you don't doubt your phone going to work. You understand? You don't go to bed thinking, I wonder will I have internet tomorrow. You know what I'm saying? Something we already trust the world without even a second thought. But then sometimes at the first steps of faith, at the first steps of our walk, you understand, or when we still are taking those baby steps, we do have those kind of, because that's the other mind. That's us going through that temptation. So we have to look at how Christ overcame those temptations. And we know that he made that an example for us so that we will be able to overcome these temptations, whether they are within us or whether they are outside of us. You know, so that's why I went through that portion of scripture as well, you know, as well, because it's little, but it's talawa. It's a little thing there, you know what I'm saying? It's a little point, but as you walk in, as you walk in it, you begin to see, you know, it really makes a whole lot of just even correcting what you say out your own mouth. Cause a lot of times we're cursing ourselves. You know what I mean? Yeah, so, I don't know whether we're going to adjourn this at this time, but I would you know, if there's some questions or some basics, you know, to be reason on regarding this particular matter and this Rastafari sabbatical is the new posting site for the Sabbath portions, and that's on. That's on YT on YouTube at Rastafari Sabbath THICAL. That's the web posting right now that we are broadcasting on. Just for those who
can you
read
it?
Okay.
That's on YouTube too, right?
Yeah, that's on YouTube because that's the main highway and byway that we can reach out to the brothers and sisters, you know, until they start something new. Yeah, we're gonna still use that. Yeah, you know, it's just that the other one, you know, the net. You know what I mean? The dragnet explains that mystery right there. You know what I mean? You know that there's all kind of fish. You know, there's. You know, there's different ones, like even like I mentioned recently, there's somebody who was chatting about the Black Madonna. I think it's somebody, is anybody here the one responsible? Because I'd like to chat with that guy. Whatever.com or something like that. Is it any of you responsible for whatever.com? And the silence is deafening. So I guess there's no one here, you know, no one here. Yeah, but anyway, that person tried to just kind of twist the reasoning to go into some, we must have said OJs, and they take that offense of it, but we said the other Jews. Well, they are the other Jews.
I've seen that guy, you know. That's funny because that was like the last video.
Yeah, so he's going all into that. I'm saying, wait, in that particular video, I don't think we even touched on the other Jews. We was talking about Roman Catholicism and what's been
right.
I noticed
he said that, you know, he find the term OJ offensive, and I was like, you know, I watched that vid, you know, and I didn't even say OJ in that vid.
He don't find that, but you know what it is it's because, see, look, if one start to look at, if you look at the Haile Selassie's commissioning of the Black Madonna, Kiddison Glomardium and Child, right? Right?
Yes.
If you think about it, that reverses a significant portion of the Willie Lynch curse. think about it for a moment. That when we saw the focus on, you're talking about like the white part. He's trying to say the white part has a lot to do with it too, or the white part has something. You know, we never even denied that there are some faithful, you know, brothers and sisters of other so-called colors or other nationalities. We never denied that, right?
Yeah.
But in the vid,
I was wondering
what he was talking about too.
I was wondering what he was saying when he said we had four fathers. He's like, we never said we came from the black one. He said our father had four wives, and I was like, which one of his fathers?
What he's trying to do is play on Jacob. On Jacob, Jacob had two wives, his sisters Leah and Rachel, and Bilhah and Zilla and Zilla. I think Bilhah and Zilpah. Thank you. You could have tied a name. Yeah. So he's trying to play on that to say that, you know, this is probably one of the, you know, they're trying to find reasons for, well, why the root is black and then they are maybe Ashkenazi or coming out of Europe, instead of admitting that they basically, you know, were converts to the faith.
Right.
So they're trying to make, argument, like perhaps one of the concubines was this or that or the next thing, and it's just some useless argument, basically. But what it is really, you know, it was the Holy Spirit told me, it's not what he's saying on the surface. It's not what a lot of, you know, it's when somebody is like critiquing you or whatnot, and it's not what you did, and you can't figure it out. It's almost like this temptation or this, it's like a trick mode. It's like man was created very good, and then he gets an offer of good and evil. And he doesn't figure out it's a trick. Why would I exchange my very good for your good and evil? You know what I mean?
Exactly.
You know, why would I exchange something better? But it's a trick. It's like what the devil trying to do with Yeshua. Adonino exposed that right there. He said, if you cast yourself down, you know, from this pinnacle, then you know what is written in David or written in the Psalms, that he shall bear you in their wings and your foot won't dash against a stone. And Christ rebuked him. Why? Because what he was saying is commit suicide and God will save you. Can you imagine how many people probably did commit suicide thinking God was going to save them?
Right, exactly. That, and it has happened.
Ah, it was almost like,
know?
It's like that in that issue of High Times, the one that talk about the Bob Marley conspiracy about the you know, the Nazi scientists. In the same article, they had somewhere in Jamaica, they had a bingy, and some brethren or some Rasta man basically that they said was mentally disturbed or this or that. That was mentally disturbed or whatnot like that. He basically sat down in the fire, and he, oh my goodness. No, I'm just, we were just scrolling on the internet, and we're seeing these Ethiopians running around with all these white Jesus, washed out white Jesus pictures.
Yes.
I mean, this picture here looks like just a whole bunch of little children. It's like, my goodness. Oh, wow. My goodness, I have no goodness.
I do have one point, and this is just because, you know, the scripture says a lie lasts for a moment, but the truth is everlasting, right? So on the internet, the Diary of a Hollywood Street King, has anyone seen that?
No.
Diary of a Hollywood Street King, it's a big article that says something like, a lying lion. It's like calling that Snoop Dogging his new Rastafarian religion. Anyway, the lying exposed. So I just wanted to say, you know.
Oh, yeah. I heard something. I just see a vid.
Lying exposed.
Mm.
So praise Jah for the Holy Spirit and truth, the Spirit of truth. So.
You know. Amen. You know what we need to do?
Definitely.
We need to get some posters.
The world is seeing, and this is a worldly man who's saying he is not. It is a worldly man testifying that this is not Rastafarianism. And he mentioned Haile Selassie. So.